Wednesday is what, my friends, okay? Hopefully we get a good whopper! There it is! It shows its tail! It has lapped the water with its chin. This time we have it different during this time of the year also, because this is the breeding time for them. Sometimes the males compete against each other, trying to impress the females, showing they're strong and healthy, doing big jumps, slapping water with their pectoral fins, with their tails. Sometimes these competitions become very aggressive between them. They start hitting each other between the males. This is breeding area for humpback whales. And this is also nursing area. Sometimes we see the mamas with their newborns, with the baby ones. There's humpback whales. The two whales at 11 o'clock are humpbacks, and the other whale jumping by the horizon, there was another humpback whale. Everybody, attention to see where these whales come up to the surface. They were swimming this way. Maybe coming around 9 o'clock, 8 o'clock on the left side. Or they maybe can swim below us and come on the 3 o'clock. So everybody will have to be paying attention. Once the whale shows their fluke, the tail, that means they're diving deep, probably taking a few minutes to come up to the surface, maybe 5, 7, 10 minutes. Humpback whales got capacity to hold their breath for more than 20 minutes when they're traveling long distances. So I hope this whale does not last too much underwater. Or they can maybe come up to the surface with a big jump, so that's why you have to be attention all the way around. Of the plan. Here they are, two humpback whales, adults size. These are adult size humpbacks. And every size adult humpback, the adult humpback ranges in a length from the 40 to the 55 feet long, and the weight of an adult humpback is approximately 40 to 45 tons. My friends on the left side, please also remember that, as we say, that remain sitting down for the people on the right side can take a look. Also, people who's gotten a spot, sit down. If you got chairs, if you got, if you're sitting on the left side, benches, just remain sitting down for the people on the right side can take a look.
Good catch.
Big wave in the front. It's part of the show. It's part of the ride. If you got backpacks on the floor, you better put them on the benches or in the saloon.
They might get wet.
Well, good to know a little bit more information about these type of whales. All the whales belong to the baleen family of whales, characterized by having baleen plates, where people didn't put from water instead of having to eat. They got small trout, humpback whales eat all these small things like the krill, plankton, small fish. They feed only during the summer months in colder waters. Humpback whales during this time of the year survive by their body fat. They feed in the summer months in colder waters. Totally different behavior during that time of the year. And there, during the feeding time, you can see the big groups and large spots. During this time of the year, they travel alone, mother with babies, or in small groups. Use many different methods to feed, including the bubble net feeding technique. Sometimes they do it in groups, sometimes they do it by itself, the bubble net feeding technique. They start swimming around the school of fish, making a net with the bubble surface. Okay, I think I'm explaining this in a little bit later. It's now at the surface. Lasting around 4 or 5 minutes underwater and then showing up again, swimming by the surface. Humpback whale has a distinctive body shape with unusually long pectoral fins and a black dorsal coloring, easy to identify by their stocky bodies with obvious humps and the black dorsal coloring. There's another one. Coming up, there he is. claws of the ball so nice and smooth by the surface.
Wow, can you see?
Coming up, 10 o'clock, you can see the shape. You can see their pectoral fins in the low part. It's white, so that's the tails. Look at those little tails. Now they went down deep, probably taking a few more minutes to come up to the surface. This time we're gonna time it. Did you see how the tail is different? Every single whale have different marking and patterns in the on the tail. It works like a fingerprint for them also, for the biologists. So they have an estimated population of these whales. They take pictures of the tails. And it works like a fingerprint. And also the gray whales, the orcas, or killer whales. Alright, this is one of the purpose of this migration, to be away from these predators. The water temperature is warm right here for the orcas. But even like that, we have seen groups of orcas in this water trying to chase and eat the baby ones. But it's so unusual, but we have seen groups of orcas traveling to these warm waters. They don't sleep for long, just a few days, and they start heading back to the colder waters. But we have seen groups of orcas. Is what is right. Oh no, I was sorry, my friend. Sorry, I saw this glance of the ball there. Right? Too much tequila. Sorry. Fans alive. Willy.
Yeah.
We will have to do our whale call. This also, the humpback whales produce complex whale songs, which last for 10 to 20 minutes. And it's repeated for hours at a time. The purpose of these songs is not yet clear. I think it appears to have a rolling mating. That's how they get attention also from the females doing these whale calls, these whale songs. Listen to another whales from 1,000 miles away from each other. This is one of the loudest noises underwater. Some of the whales use echolocation, like the sperm whales. They do the echolocation to identify whatever is in the front of them and the distances as they are swimming deep waters. They use their eyes very much. I'm talking about deep whales such as the orcas, sperm whales, dolphins. They use the echolocation. But these whales are more depend more from their eyes, so that's why they don't swim very deep. They stay a little bit more by the surface. Like the humpback whales, gray whales, blue whales. Farther than that water taxi. There they blow. way out there. My friends is turning to Ralph on this side on the Pacific Ocean. We're gonna turn around trying to find some whales at the Sea of Cortez or Gulf of California. And there are too many boats around these whales. So sometimes when there's too many boats, they try to avoid us, you know? Sometimes they don't feel comfortable with many boats around, too much noise of the waters. That disturbs them sometimes. Especially when they're in the breeding time or in the gestation period, you know? Sometimes they don't feel comfortable with this too many noises around. All the time, the next city down until we turn around point today, go from California, our Sea of Cortez, trying to find some more whales. We hope you're having a good time so far. Nice. We're lucky to see this couple of puppets. So close. Hopefully we see some more.
Gracias, amigos.
You ready?
No, gracias.
Can you do it again? Because I didn't have my big camera. You're too fast.
Do you have more money?
Well, I didn't get the picture. It was too